Kesler wins the draw back. Alexander Enner has the puck. Henrik Sedin in for Alex Burrows to Daniel Sedin. Kesler trying to get open in front. Henrik gets the puck under 20 seconds to go. Alexander Enner over to Henrik Sedin to the net. He scores! Sedin to the net. Ryan Kesler with the tip-in.
Kesler gets inside position, and this is just a perfect tip. Look at the reaction. Glenn said he wanted the game on his stick. Well, it comes right back to them there. Just perfectly executed. A floater through, and the tip down and underneath the arm of Niemi.
Daniel to Bieksa. Takes the shot. Takes the shot. Blocked by Huskins. Burrows is fresh. Knocked the puck loose to Edler. Back in for Alex Burrows. It's up in the air. Score!
I think that hit the mesh, didn't it?
The puck looked like it was out of play, but it stayed in. Kevin Bieksa took the shot. Vancouver's won it in double overtime. And the Vancouver Canucks are going to the Stanley Cup Final.
And if it wasn't the mesh, guys, it's not reviewable.
Hit the stanchion and came right back. What a heads-up play by Kevin Bieksa. Nobody knows where that puck is. Off the stanchion and right back, and look at the reaction.
Most of all, Antti Niemi had no clue. Kevin Bieksa gets the goal, and Vancouver's won the fifth game that's been so elusive for them in these playoffs, and the Canucks are back to the final for the first time since 94.
Niemi trying to get some answers. He had no idea where that puck was. The only guy who did, as Edler hits it, it hits the stanchion, comes right back. But watch Edler. Nobody's looking at where it is. A knuckle puck that goes right inside the post.
You're right. You look at the body language. Nobody knows where the puck is except Bieksa. Even his Canuck teammates had no clue that the puck had come to him.
And you see Burrows there quickly jumped down and got that puck. 12 wins in the books. Four to go to win the Stanley Cup.
How about the series for Bieksa, though? You think about the game-tying goal, game two late, then they win that one. Big goal tonight.
Ryan Kesler could use the rest. Roberto Luongo with 54 saves to get this halfway through the second overtime. And what an awful, hollow feeling for Antti Niemi, having no idea where the puck was.
It's amazing how one bounce can change your destiny. And for the Canucks, a great season, a great series, and a great moment for that man there.
Matty Malhotra lost late in the season, unable to play in the playoffs, out to the bench to join the celebration. Former Shark sees his former teammates heading off. Kevin Bieksa.
You think about this building a few years back, they had the different glass, and now with the new stanchions, that leads to the biggest goal in 17 years in this building. Elliot.
Down into the mayhem.
Your coaches tell you to live in the moment. Tell us about this moment.
This was an awesome game to play in. We knew what was at stake, and we did a great job of staying in the moment. We went down and we battled right to the end, and you know, we scored a great goal, and Hanky threw it on that great tip, and you know, just happy right now.
Ryan, I had to tell you that we were watching you when you tried to come back in the second period. And kind of had to wonder if there was any way you were going to be able to play. Did it ever come close to you saying, I can't go tonight?
No, I'll play on one leg. I don't care. It's all about the team right now. And, I had to do it for them.
Playing for the Stanley Cup. You know you're going to do it now. What does it mean?
It's what we play for. Dreamed about it my whole life. And, to be in this situation with this team, we're excited. But we know we still got a job ahead of us.
Thanks very much, Ryan. Jim?
Well, there'll soon be a presentation of the Clarence Campbell Trophy for the winners of the Western Conference. Another look at the goal that sends the Cup, or the Canucks, to the Stanley Cup Final. One man knew where it was, and he just about fanned on it. But Niemi had no idea, so he couldn't make a save. And there's the reaction on the streets of Vancouver. Their teams going to the Stanley Cup Finals for the first time since 94. Mike Gillis, Lawrence Gilman, Lorne Henning, Stan Smeal. And the bench.
That's the eighth goal by a defenseman for the Canucks this series.
Well, let's join public address announcer and these fans of John Ashbridge and 18,860 who are still in the building for the presentation of the Clarence Campbell Trophy.
Ladies and gentlemen, NHL Deputy Commissioner Bill Daly will now present the Clarence Campbell Trophy to the captain of your Vancouver Canucks, Henrik Sedin.
In 1982, Stan Smeal lifted it up. In 1994, Trevor Linden had the lid fall off when he did the same. In 2011, the captain of the Canucks isn't going to touch this trophy. In what has become an unusual superstition, more often than not, teams don't want that one. They're waiting for the other one.
The journey is only three-fourths the way, and they understand there's a lot of work yet to be done.
This is Trevor Linden accepting this trophy. Had no problem picking it up and lifting it up, and then it fell apart. That was in 94. On this day, 17 years ago, Vancouver advanced. Boston and Tampa to play tomorrow.
They get a dry run here with all the stuff on the ice. If this was the Stanley Cup parade, the players can't even get around.
Whose dumb idea was it to let 2 tons of paper hit the ice?
That would sort of...
Down in this mayhem somewhere is Elliot.
With the goal scorer, it looked like you were the only guy in the building who knew what was going on with that puck.
Yeah, what a fortunate bounce. I think it hit the partition over there and came out in the slot. And what a shot. It was such a duck, too, and it just barely got in on the ice, but we'll take it.
What do you think when they saw the puck go in the net?
Let's go to the Cup. Let's go to the Cup Finals. That's the first thing I thought about. What a feeling. You work so hard your whole life, and to do it with this group of guys, can't wait to get there.
You are a Vancouver organization guy. You've been here through thick and thin. To stand here right now to look around at all of this, put it into words.
Yeah, it makes it that much better to be in this great organization since day one, and been with the core guys for 7 years, and we worked hard to get to this point, and we're going to go celebrate now and get ready for a big Stanley Cup Finals.
You saw Kesler go into the room hurt. He scored that goal to send this game into overtime. Everybody plays hurt at this time of year. What does that do to a team to see him do that?
It just shows how much everybody in this room wants it. The guys sacrificing their bodies and playing hurt and doing whatever it takes to win. Louis stood on his head in overtime the first period. He played great. It's a total team effort tonight.
Dan Hamhuis, Tanner Glass said yesterday that Dan Hamhuis was saying, can you envision having the cup? Do you envision that? Do you know, you're 4 wins away, but it's so close. Do you think of that?
I think right now, just going to the Cup Finals is a great feeling. A lot of hard work ahead of us, but Well, hopefully we get there.
Thanks very much, Kevin.
Thanks, Elliot.
All right, Jim?
And good luck, Kevin, getting off the ice. A number of his teammates were stumbling and having to walk like little old men to get through all of this paper and into the dressing room. And he's got a carpet that he can walk on. Roberto Luongo's down on the ice with Elliot now.
Well, we were saying that Kevin Bieksa looked like he was the only guy in the building who knew the puck was. You were down at the other end. Did you see it unfolding in front of you?
I did see him shoot it, but I didn't see it go in. It was bouncing all the way in, and I wasn't sure if he any got in or not, but obviously I saw the light go on, and Kevin raised his arm, so he jacked up.
Well, you made some unbelievable saves tonight, 54 of them. He made some unbelievable saves tonight. Did you get the feeling that it was going to take something like that to end this game?
It always does, doesn't it? It always feels like OT goals are always a weird bounce or something like that, but it was a battle. It was a tough one tonight. It was a big battle for both sides, and it seemed like nobody wanted to bend, but obviously we got the break when we needed it.
15 months ago, you stood here and went through the greatest victory of your life. You're now four wins away from maybe an even greater victory, Roberto.
Yeah, I am. I mean, this is nothing compared to the Olympics. I mean, it's so such a grind. I mean, every night you got to battle it out. Battle of the wills, battle of the minds, anything you think of. And it's just fun to play hockey right now.
Final question for you. I heard after game three, you went into the room and said, sorry, guys, my bad, on the power play goal. And tonight, you have a feeling you're going to be going in there and they're all going to be saying to you, this was your night, you carried us.
Yeah, you know, that's my job. I try to make the saves, you know, when I have to. Obviously, I made a bit of a mistake on the second one, a bad read by my part, but the guys bailed me out with 10 seconds left, and that's what we've done all year. I mean, when somebody's maybe not playing as well, somebody else picks it up. There's a different guy chipping in every night, and that's what makes us successful this year.
Thank you very much. Congratulations.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
Jim.
He's right. They've had performances from all over the place, from the second liners and the Yannick Hansons on the third lines, and a defenseman. 8 goals in the series, none bigger than this, and a crazier bounce you will not see. He called it a duck.
And a 1-2-3 hopper, like a stone on the Pacific Ocean, right by an unsuspecting Antti Niemi. Strange plays, strange bounces. That's what overtimes are all about.
Both teams extremely skilled, but Vancouver, to me, combined will with skill. And when you combine will with skill, you win a series. And that's exactly what they did over the past 5 hockey games.
17 years ago tonight, it was Greg Adams in overtime. Double overtime that sent Vancouver to the Cup Final against the New York Rangers. Tonight it's Kevin Bieksa from Grimsby, Ontario, out of Bowling Green University, in double overtime that sends the Vancouver Canucks to the Stanley Cup Final against Tampa or Boston.